In this example, the figure shows a semicircular wire loop of resistance R and radius A hinged at point O and rotating at an angular speed omega, which we can see in the figure. It is saying that point O is located on the boundary of a uniform magnetic induction B. Here we can see on the right side of the boundary, a uniform magnetic induction B exists, and on left side there is no magnetic induction. It is asking to plot the current as a function of time in the loop, taking clockwise direction of current as positive. We need to take here theta is equals to 0 at t equals to 0. Now here we can see when the loop is rotating, its semicircular segment of wire is not cutting any magnetic line. Only the radial length OB is cutting magnetic lines. So an EMF is induced in OB, which can be given by that of a motional EMF of a rotating rod about one point. So we can write here EMF induced in OB is, this EMF we can write as half B omega A square. And here if we just have a look on the free electrons of the wire due to the motion toward right, these will experience magnetic force in inward direction. B will be high potential point, O will be low potential point. So due to this EMF we can see an anti-clockwise current is produced, and here induced current in loop can be given as I will be E by R, that can be written as B omega A square by 2R. And when theta becomes pi, that is after duration t equals to pi by omega, that is half rotation, this OB will come out of the field and OA will enter into the field. And as soon as OA will enter, A will be the high potential point, and due to that a clockwise current starts flowing. So initially it was anti-clockwise, and we can write after t is equals to pi by omega, current will be same, that is B omega A square by 2R, but its direction will be clockwise. And again after half rotation this current will start. So if we wish to plot the graph of current as a function of time, here we can write from initial time 0 to pi by omega, the current will remain negative constant and the value will be at minus B omega A square by 2R. And at t equals to pi by omega, it changes to positive. The value, the magnitude will remain same, B omega A square by 2R. And again, after half cycle at t equals to 2 pi by omega, it changes to negative. Then again at 3 pi by omega, it changes to positive. And so on. So this will be the answer to our problem, that is the plot of current as a function of time in the loop.